Hello and welcome to the series of UiPath Orchestrator API using Orchestrator HTTP request activity. In the last video, we got the brief about Orchestrator API and we got to know that we can use Orchestrator API through our UiPath Studio also and access our Orchestrator component. To use Orchestrator API, UiPath has provided Orchestrator HTTP request activity in the studio. Also, we have seen that what is the difference between HTTP request and Orchestrator HTTP request activity. In my upcoming videos, we're going to implement a lot of things like we'll be running our job, creating queues, assets, queue item, and much more using Orchestrator HTTP request activity. But before moving on to the implementation part, we need to do some configuration. So in this video, we're going to see about Orchestrator HTTP request activity and properties of it, and what configuration we need to do to access our Orchestrator component using API. So UiPath has given very nice explanation in this document regarding Orchestrator HTTP request activity, and I'll give you the link of this document in description box for your reference. Moving on to the properties of Orchestrator HTTP request, it is having a common property which is common to all activities of UiPath. So one is continue on error, which specify if automation should continue even error occur for that activity. Second is display name, which is name of that activity. Third is timeout MS, which specify wait time for the activity to run before an error is thrown. So this activity takes a three input, which is JSON payload, method, and relative endpoint. So JSON payload is the information that we want to send to our endpoint in the JSON format, like in a key value pair, but as a string or a string variable. A method is a HTTP method like get, post, put, delete, etc. The relative endpoint, which is an endpoint to make a request to API. Relative means you don't need to mention your orchestrator URL in the endpoint. Only we need to mention the endpoint to access a specific orchestrator component. How we can provide a relative endpoint to this activity, we'll get to know in my next video. The most important thing, we need to make sure that our robot or assistant is connected to our orchestrator, as this activity will refer that orchestrator tenant and provide us the access to the component. You might have seen in my previous series of Orchestrator API using Postman, when we are calling or invoking Orchestrator API from Postman or any other application, we first need to authenticate and need an access token to access orchestrator component. But using this activity to access orchestrator component, we don't need to authenticate or don't need to generate a token. We can directly access any component such as logs, robot, machine, etc. Isn't UiPath made easy for us to access orchestrator API by providing this activity? Coming on to the output of this activity, it returns JSON response, which is a JSON written by HTTP request as a string, and status code, which is a status code written by HTTP request, such as 200, 201, 400, etc. Till now, you got the properties of Orchestrator HTTP request activity. So let's move on to the configuration that we have to make to access our Orchestrator data. So why configuration are needed to use Orchestrator data using Orchestrator HTTP request activity? Because for each HTTP request, you might need different write on orchestrator robot role depending on what request you're doing. For example, to run put request on organization unit, you need view, create, edit permission. So you can explore more about orchestrator robot role by going to this link. I just talked about some permissions, which is create, view, delete. So let's see how we can do configuration and what are these permissions and all. And to do the configuration, role page of orchestrator enable us to manage the user permission. And to open the role page, we need to go to our orchestrator. Then we need to go to our user tab. So suppose I have a robot role. By clicking on edit button, I can manage the permission here. So the permission are view, edit, create and delete. These are the permission for each component of orchestrator, like alerts, licenses, machines, packages, folders, users, etc. So for user to gain the permission, you have to assign the role. In this case, I need to assign role to the user, which is my robot. So I can do that by creating a new role or by giving some specific permissions to access the orchestrator component to any specific role. So let's say a robot, I will assign some specific permissions to this role, and then I will assign this role to my user, which is my robot. So if you are confused and not getting which permission should assign for which HTTP request, so don't worry. I have a simple alternative, which is assigning an administrator role to our user. Admin role, which is a default role, comes with the all tenant level permission. I will show you how to assign admin role to any specific user. So this is our admin role. And these are the permissions are assigned for our admin role for each orchestrator component. We cannot change any permissions for our administrator role. So I'll assign this role to our user, which is my robot. To do that, we need to simply go to users, edit. Here it is showing that user my robot is having a role called robot, but we need to assign an administrator role to it. So we just simply need to click here and we need to select the admin role. Then we need to click on update. Now we are ready to access orchestrator component using orchestrator HTTP request activity. I will quickly summarize the configuration. First, a robot or assistant should be connected to orchestrator. Second, we don't need any authentication or a token to use our orchestrator data using orchestrator HTTP request activity. Third, we have to assign different permissions to our role, and that role we need to assign to our user depending on which HTTP request we are calling. And alternative to this, we can simply assign admin role to our user and then we can call any HTTP request. So that's all for now. In the next video, we'll see how we can access our folder data using orchestrator HTTP request activity in the studio. Till then, happy learning. Thank you.